Oh yeah. Woos were made for to be spoken. Love was made for devotion. Half promises were made for to be kept. This is true, but I was made for the blues. Lovin' was made for the future, and fools were made for the loser. Happiness was made for the someone and you, but I was made for the blues. Yes, I was made for the blues, but by now I'm getting used to the heartaches I have to go through. Yesterday was made for tomorrow, and troubles were made for just for sorrow. Loving was made for future and you, but I was made for the blues. Yes, I was made for the blues. So I pop open the screen and it's all blue. And it's the amazing, amazing synchronicity because earlier in the day this song popped into my head. I was made for the blues. And I said, ah yeah, I'm made for the blues. What is the blues? The blues, the blue, the blue. Well, we'll find out in this video. I was made for the blues. Yes, I was. So I dial up the song on the internet. I don't know the lyrics so well, so I was stumbling around, singing quietly too. I'm outside, and it's what time is it? It's 9 o'clock, so I don't want to wake up the neighbors. What a great song that is by George Jones, "Made for the Blues," "Made for the Blues." So I'm sitting here, and we're sitting here together. The WoW Racing team is together. The WoW Racing team got members all over the world. Great drivers in the WoW Racing team all over the world. Why racing team? Because we're going really fast, right? We're going really fast. And of course, the WoW Racing team is headed up by Juan Carlos. If we can ever find him. He's elusive. As soon as you think you found him, he's already gone. He's already gone. As soon as you think you found Juan Carlos, he's already gone. So the way to find him is to don't think. Right? Don't think you found him. And then you found him. So, yeah, gotta have a lot of really great races around the world here. And a lot of interesting helpers. A lot of Dakinis. It's funny. Different ways, different people in different ways they trigger something and I say, ah, yes. So I just, you know, I just, I'm getting a lot of friend requests now, you know, and like, I don't know why they're requesting my friendship. But, last couple of days, I said, okay, I mean, what they're into is not really what we're doing, but everybody helps me out. Everybody helps out this racing team, the WoW Racing team. We're a team that goes really fast here. It goes really fast. Now, the blues, made for the blues. What's the blues? The blues. Well, that's a symbol of ultimate reality, actually. in Tibetan Buddhism, blue, Samantabhadra, God, the ultimate ground of being, inherent spaciousness is symbolized by blue. Blue. The highestness is symbolized by this dark blue. So we turn on this video and it's dark blue, and I can't get the controls to pop up to adjust it. It took me a long time. I think they're finally up now somewhere. Maybe we can pop out of the blue right now. Oh yeah. I love to keep expectations low. Oh, there it is. This one, little one's right there, needs to pop up. Okay, this will be a boom. Here we are. People say, "Why don't you sing better?" I say, "Why? I want to keep expectations low. Someday I may have to really sing, and I don't want y'all. You know, if you get expectations high, you always got to top your expectations." People say, "Well, you can top that." You know, so I don't. I try not to sing too well. And then if I sing well, people say, "Oh, wow, that's so much better! Wow," you know. So don't come up with your highest, you know, expectations, everybody. Keep your expectations a little bit low, but not too low, not too low. Then you get trapped in your own marketing scheme. You know, this is a problem. Some people have self-effacing people. That strategy is actually a strategy that people use here, to kind of. It works pretty well in this world. Like, I'm just a little Mr. Miss Nothing, and I don't know anything, and this, that. Because people then underestimate you, which can be a great advantage. You have low expectations, so you always seem to keep, you know, going better. Well, that's a very effective strategy, playing the fool. But there's a great trap that we must avoid, all of us. And that is, you start believing in your own marketing device, your own devices, that you really are. Stupid and lowly, and you know, I can't sing at all. I'm not very good at all. And then you start believing that, and you believe in your own little scheme here, you see. And then you're trapped, right? So this happens to a lot of us, women and men both. I see it in both. But women, you often see this. It is. They downplay, and then they get trapped in the downplaying, thinking that they really are, you know, not so good. And then they stall out. This trouble. But anyone who does this, you have to be very careful. So it's a fine line. You know, coming out and saying, "Yeah, I am really pretty doggone great at what I do," then the expectations are raised and people expect this of you. So it's a tough thing to do. The Longchenpa said, "You told me I'm a Dharma prince." I said, "Wow, you know, I like playing the fool, Longchenpa, you know. I mean, I like flying under the radar." And then he's saying, "Ah, you know, you might, can you consider like flying a little higher? You know, can you come under the radar?" And I say, "Wow, okay, I'll give it a try here." So I'm trying. My tendency is to fly under the radar. I found that helps you go fast. Don't draw too much attention. A lot of the attention, you know, it's like, okay, what's exactly this or that? I'll tell you. But like, I don't know. It's all synchronicity, though. It's amazing. The people that pop up, everyone pops up is just helping you. If you realize that, maybe just a little thing. Maybe they're just here to just give you a little help here, a little help there, or a lot of help. Or, you know, everyone's different. Somebody today asked me for my phone number. First time anyone's ever done that. A younger person that I've been discussing some heavy issues with. He's very advanced in his way. And he said, "You know what?" He said today, I'm just in this wow." I said, "Whoa, that's great." I said, "It's either wow or despair. Either wow the day, or are you despair the day?" And he says, "Yeah." And then he asked for my phone number. I gave it to him. He said, "We'll stay in touch." It's amazing. Somebody asked me, I gave it to him. First time ever. And so he, you know, he has something, you know, to help. He's helped us out already, our racing team out, by turning me on to these videos by Brett Novak, which then inspired me to start making videos, shorter videos. I said, hey, short videos can be cool. I can do it. And I've been doing it, and I like the way they've turned out. I'm actually very pleased about it. And of course, it's actually Manjushri, Longchenpa, who's doing the videos. Now, who is this Manjushri? Well, this Manjushri really was Buddha. What we call Shakyamuni Buddha or Gautama Buddha was really Manjushri. It was a play of Manjushri. Manjushri is like the ultimate bodhisattva, meaning that the principle of commitment to helping us all get free of our our absurdity, our folly, our continuity fear, really. So, you know, is it like the Holy Spirit? You would say yes, it's like the Holy Spirit. But we don't, you know, labels, tricky things. Manjushri is just this. The play of Manjushri was what's known as Buddha historically. And the play of Longchenpa, the wisdom of Longchenpa, is known as Manjushri too. Manjushri appeared as Longchenpa, who's called, interestingly enough, the second Buddha. Okay, now, so this Manjushri is, through Longchenpa, has been contacting me, and, you know, I've agreed to be part of Manjushri's team for now. And so I'm getting help from Manjushri. A lot of help, actually. The Manjushri, one of the great lineages of Manjushri is the Nyingma Masters, which goes through all the way down to Jamyang Kenshi Choki Lodo, who was more ecumenical, but he was very schooled in Nyingma teachings. Dilgo Khyentse Rinpoche, you know, before that, Jigme Lingpa, many great masters, so many great masters in Nyingma lineage. It Padmasambhava started it, you know. It's just Vimala Mitra, Yana Sutra. I'm not quite sure of all the names, but it doesn't matter, right? The greatness is there, and it's Manjushri is behind this. Manjushri means gentle glory. Gentle glory, and his Manjushri's approach is wisdom, prajna, wisdom. And what's been happening is, I appealed to Manjushri for help, and suddenly I've been getting all these practices that are extremely advanced, and understanding them and able to practice them. These are Manjushri practices. These are practices that the Buddha recommended. Okay, the Buddha is Manjushri, really. Actually, so we are in part of this transmission here, Bodhisattva transmission, which is as good as it gets here. This is very, very profound, actually. And reading Longchenpa, what he has to say, his perspective, you know, nobody has ever expressed spiritual truth better than Longchenpa. No one has ever topped it. No one has ever topped that. I would say it's so astonishingly apt. And that's Manjushri, actually. Gentle glory of wisdom. Isn't it wisdom wonderful? I love it. So I'm very much along that path. This is the path that I have always taken, is wisdom. Clarity, wisdom, reason, clarity, wisdom, reason, clarity. Just calmly, patiently, gently applying wisdom and reason. That's what I've done. So it's not a surprise that Manjushri says, hey, you're part of my team. This is so. Let me support my team. I support my team. It's very important to get this through. Manjushri, the head of a team, is all supportive for the team members. Just like you would be. If you're running a business and you want to be super successful, helpful businesses, you would be very supportive of your employees and the morale of your employees, wouldn't you? So, Manjushri seems to be a bit abstract. If you want to make it less abstract, Longchenpa. Okay. But abstract is good too. What does Manjushri have? Great practices is what I found. Super practices. Now, we talked about the blue, the ocean, the blue. Blue can symbolize the ocean, too. And there's this great practice that Manjushri is helping us with. And some of you are actually already tuned in to Manjushri, Longchenpa, Jamyang Kenshi, Choki Lodro. Already tuned in to this. or tuned in through other teachers like Ram Maharshi, Jesus Christ, Sri Sri Anandamaya Ma, Padmasambhava, etc. Nisargadatta Maharaj, Punjaji, lots of other teachers already tuned in to this higher practice. As Buddha said, the wise are already on the other side. They're already on the other side. This is Manjushri. This is the teaching, the already teaching. You might call Manjushri the already teaching. That's one way. And so, imagine we're sitting on this beautiful island. Gorgeous, this gorgeous land. And there's this great ocean. In fact, it's an infinite ocean, you might say. And we're sitting there on the beach. And imagine that we've lost ourself. Somewhere out in that ocean. We don't know what happened, where it went. It's utterly lost. Ourself is utterly lost. In all directions, boundlessly lost, inexpressibly lost. This is so important to look at this. Is just you're sitting there on the beach and we accept that our self is inexpressibly lost. What we're used to thinking of as our self, okay? The I, we say myself, is inexpressibly, boundlessly inexpressibly lost. Inexpressibly lost, without any trace whatsoever of where it might be. And this is just introducing a practice. I was doing this practice before. I was doing it pretty well. Right now, not quite as well because I'm talking about it. And our job is just to sit there quietly and don't do anything. Just sit there and absorb it. That this I is completely lost. This ocean goes on forever. It's like space, the universe. This ocean, forever goes on forever. Seems to, doesn't it? And the I. The self is disappeared into the boundless depths and breadth and scope of this infinite ocean is simply completely disappeared. So we can practice this and just let it now. For me, like I'm still holding on to this moment for some hope, like, well, at least it's somewhere. But when you get to the practice, it's like it's irretrievably gone. Irretrievably gone. And it's irretrievably gone in all directions. And in no direction. And it's traceless, completely traceless. Irretrievably gone and traceless. So, we've got the blues. We're thinking, oh, okay. So you just sit there in the blues and say, it's okay. All right. Let me just experience this. I'll never have myself again. Inexpressibly, tracelessly vanished. And all I see is this infinite ocean now. All the same. Goes on forever. Now imagine that there's this self made of salt. And while you were sleeping, the ocean tide came in. This is your friend, the salt friend. You think it's yourself. You call it I, self. Name has a name. Your name. It's your buddy. You carry it around everywhere. And the tide came up and dissolved this your salt friend. Completely dissolved it. And you wake up and you realize what happened is your salt, your friend now is completely dissolved as salt in this infinite ocean. Very subtle salt too. It spreads out through everywhere. So it's just completely spread out everywhere. Dissolved with all other salt, just in a complete unity now. And so there's no way, it's impossible to ever get that salt friend back. So you're without your salt friend. And yet, the salt that your friend was made of, that salt is present everywhere in the ocean, actually, isn't it? Everywhere you go, the taste of salt is there. So your friend now is formless, yet it's still there. The essence of it is still there, as the salty water of the sea. But there's no more form to your friend at all. Irretrievably, irreversibly. Practice this irretrievably, irreversibly ness. Completely lost, totally lost to you, totally, completely lost. So these practices are various skillful means. Another one that Manjushri has given us is practice doing nothing. Look out upon the vast ocean, calm vast ocean, and just realize the ocean's doing nothing. It's just like just sitting there. So you're just doing nothing like that ocean. Now, what this does is it dries up all your bad habits, dries up all habits, but basically all our habits are bad habits. Except this one of practicing. Everything else is really bad habits, really, if you get right down to it. And so, evaporating all our habits, how do we evaporate them? By doing nothing. So when, like, it's like if you want to get weak, just don't exercise, right? You'll atrophy. So habits atrophy. The bad habits just atrophy because you're not doing anything. That means you're not doing your bad these bad habits. So they will atrophy and wither. This is a sure way to succeed. So I'm getting used to the heartache I gotta go through. I'm getting used to it. I'm getting used to, oh, I lost myself. Don't think about it. Just say, so you know, it's happened. It's gone. Never to return. I can never get it back. Yet I'm still here. Awareness that I've lost the self is still here. Nobody knows how the self got lost. Nobody knows where the self got lost. There's just complete ignorance about it. No information at all, okay? You have zero information of what happened to the self. No information at all. This is a practice. You have no information at all as what happened to it. It's just gone. Without a trace. Like it never was. The self is gone like it never was. Gone without a trace. We mean, you know, the small self, personal self, I self, seer self, some Ramaharshi used the term self, a capital self, to refer to the true self, the ultimate self. I guess it's a little confusing if you use the term well, self, but you know, the myself is gone. Myself is gone. Myself is vanished without any information or trace at all. From any direction. Every direction you turn in, it's the same blankness, absolute blankness. Total blank on any information. Complete total blank. That's all you're seeing. So, these are some of the Manjushri practices. There are others. They're similar. They're in the same vein. So, many are coming to me easily. I practice them all day, actually. Go from one to the other as I'm driving, doing things. They keep bubbling up. Say, oh, I can do this. I can try this. I can try this. Now, it's important in these practices to do not search for results at all. Put all your concentration on just maintaining an even keel. Myself has just disappeared forever. No information on his disappearance or where it could possibly be. And it's as if this, myself never existed at all. So, we have to stay on an even keel about this. We're not searching for results of any kind. It's very important in these exercises to do not anticipate, search for any results, and don't describe anything. It's inexpressibly, it's inexpressible, completely inexpressible, completely inexpressible. Very important you accept this. It's totally inexpressible. The complete disappearance of myself, without any trace, witnesses, nothing. It's just completely inexpressible. It's as if it never was. It's as if it never was. And with it have gone all the memories, all the habits that we had, all of them are gone. All of them. So, not to have this video go too long here, trying to give shorter videos, because we're introducing the super high practice, the Manjushri practices. All ambition inexpressibly gone. All hope inexpressibly gone. All fear inexpressibly gone. All of the personality inexpressibly gone. People may talk about the self, the me, myself, and ask you, well, how did you get rid of it? It's inexpressibly gone. I have no idea what happened to it at all, except that it's vanished, completely vanished. It just isn't around anymore at all, without any explanation for it. Any direction, you know, possible to search for it. Because it's left no trace at all where it might be. Zero. Zero traces. There's not anywhere where you could even start to search for it. Because there's no notion at all where it might be. and the ocean is utterly indifferent to this, completely indifferent. You have this vast ocean of absolute indifference. Totally indifferent. The ocean is not going to help you find myself at all. It's completely indifferent. Perfectly indifferent. So we find ourselves in this situation. We just say, okay. Nothing to make of it, is there? Again, bad habits are just withering away. So don't look for results. They'll wither on their own. If you don't water something, it's going to dry up. It will dry up. So don't keep looking. Is it drying up? Just keep practicing. Don't pay attention to whether it's drying up or not. You'll notice from time to time that all of that seems a lot drier. You know, and you walk on it, it easily crunches up. Like weeds, they get real dry. It's easy to walk through them, right? Yeah. They're reduced to dust. Just keep on with this focus. No need to push it at this point. So we're just introducing these practices. It's already happened. Just accept within your mind, it's already happened. So all thought of how to make it happen, right, is useless. Completely useless. What we want to have happen has already happened. So this is a totally different mindset than trying to make something happen. We're not trying to make anything happen here at all. It's already happened. So it's just a matter of resigning ourselves to this. It's already happened. There's nothing to accomplish at all. What needs to happen has already happened. So how could there be a need to accomplish anything? There isn't. There's no need to accomplish anything whatsoever. It's already happened. Enlightenment has already been accomplished. We had nothing to do with it, actually. Nothing to do with it. It's already there. It's already happened for us. So, simply now we just enjoy it. Sort of, you know, ease along. Don't go into a temper tantrum about it. Just accept it's already happened. There's no attainment at all for me. Nothing that I do to attain anything. what I want, what I need, really need, is already there. It's already there. I didn't have anything to do with it, putting it there. Now, again, we don't search for results. Why? How could you do this then? Well, trust. I trust the teachers, the gurus, the bodhisattvas. I trust that what they're getting at, they know the results that will come for us. They've already promised ultimate results for me. So for me, then it's just like, okay, I believe them. I trust them. I believe them. They say practice in this way. That means I'll practice in this way. That's it. I don't think about it, you know, any much. I pray, I you know, prayer, receive, practice. Pray, receive, practice. PRPs, mind your PRPs. Mind your PRPs. I pray, I receive, I practice, like that. I prayed for practice. I received it. I'm practicing it. It's very simple. So when the gurus guarantee your recognition, your true happiness, that means they must know that you're going to get there, and they must know the way for you to get there. So from then on, it's just okay. You know, it's already for the, in their mind, it's a done deal. It's a done deal already. It's already done. So I'm not worried. Is this effective? Is it not effective? This it's bound to be effective. The guru's word is good enough for me. They say it's effective. I don't need to ask any more questions, right? Why? Why ask questions? If something's already done, why worry about effectiveness? It's really just a matter of accepting that it's already done. That's all we have to do. It's already here. What we've been seeking for is already here. So there's nothing we need to do to get it here. It's already here. So we just have to accept this. Anyone can do that right now, right? There's nothing that has to be done first. If something's already present, there's nothing we have to do first to make it present, right? Nothing whatsoever. And we had nothing to do with establishing what is here. It's already been here. So all the means that we thought about establishing it, the personal, the me self, don't need it at all, do we? Completely useless, gets dissolved in the ocean like a salt doll. So the salt doll is already dissolved. There's no way to get back any sort of means at all. I've lost all means, except this one means of practicing that I've lost all means. So practice, I've lost all means whatsoever. Gone. As long as we think there's means, we're thinking that it's not here right now. That's not totally present right now. How can we believe in total presence when we're still also believing in means? That something has to be, we have to do something. If something's already present, what do we have to do? other than drop our efforts to do something, right? Other than drop, that is the only doing we need to do, is just drop our efforts to realize I don't need to make any effort at all. And so the effort-based self dissolves, is gone. I don't have a clue of what happened to it. And I don't have any effort to make to the, it was effort. It says effort's gone. I don't have any capacity to make effort to find it. That's also gone, completely gone. So there's like no feeling of I need to pursue what happened to effort-based self. Is any feeling like I need to make an effort has vanished. Practice like this, it's vanished, gone. So all I do is just sit here quietly. I'm not after anything. I could never be after anything ever again. I could never be after anything ever again. I can never be after anything ever again. My shoulders hurt. They hurt all the time. I haven't cured my shoulders. Maybe I'm working out too much, but. So just imagine that you have no effort, no ability to make any effort at all. It's all gone. Your entire catalog of effort is vanished without a trace. Not even the thieves know where it is. And you can't even make any effort to ask them. All effort vanished. You can't even make an effort to think about it. What happened? Can't even make an effort to remember effort. Just no effort, zero effort's present. So just rest in this zero effort present, zero effort present. a great ocean of indifference. Another way to look at it, the ocean is absolutely indifferent, but you're already there. You're already on this land. You're already there. Doesn't matter what the ocean thinks at all. Its indifference doesn't matter. We don't need to get anything from the ocean where we at. The indifference of the ocean doesn't matter if you flip it this way. We're already in this beautiful paradise island. The indifference of the ocean to the island makes no difference to us. The ocean could care less. It doesn't even know we're there. It doesn't matter. So just imagine an ocean of absolute utter indifference to you, to your paradise island. Total indifference, and yet we have it. Already have it. We already have it. We already have it. It's already here. The indifference of the ocean, then, it makes no difference. The indifference makes no difference. Okay. Well, for some reason, I'm always tired. Going through the wow, going through the exercise, going through everything. Physical exercise, trying to keep going with that. Just everything, keeping everything going, okay? So, these practices, just, you know, get your feet wet. Just, if you can do it, do it. Practice like this, already there. Total indifference. Gone without a trace. Nothing I can do. Do nothing. Let the habits dry up. It's very abstract, right? Very abstract. These are the best practices. Nothing to grasp at all. There's nothing to grasp. The ocean's totally indifferent. What is there to grasp? It's all equally indifferent. All equally, totally indifferent. equally indifferent. There's not any part of the ocean we're looking at that has slightest interest in what we are. Totally indifferent. You could try that. I don't know what this would be. At this time of night. Oh gosh. Well, that's a sign I gotta stop. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. I better put my phone on silent. I need. Here we go. It said, the text said, here we go. I was relating to something else, but apropos to this practice, here we go, right? Here goes the stretch drive. It's really about baseball and the Giants, and here we go, meaning something good must be happening. I don't know, but it's, you know, what is the 22nd? We have like 7 more days to go or something, so I don't know what's going on with the Giants. I really don't. I don't know what's going on with the world. I don't know what the standings are. I don't know who they're playing. I don't know anything. I don't know anything about the world that's going on right now. So I have you know, indifference to it. Right, you can pretend like you have some interest or something, but I don't know what's going on in the world. Someone told me it's descending into chaos. Just turmoil. Well, the Holy Spirit told me that. Manjushri told me that. Longchenpa's told me that. Jesus told me that. So I stopped paying attention when they told me to. So I just trust them. They say it's descending into turmoil. I trust them. I look at the world. Every trend shows that, yeah, that's what's going to happen. So why pay any attention to whatsoever? None of that has anything to do with right practice, does it? Does the world ever tell you right practice? Never does. Never does. Nothing there. Nothing to see there. And I've already succeeded. So there's nothing that the world can do to change that at all. It's already happened. You can never make it unhappen. So the world is useless in that regard, completely useless. I can't use the world to attain anything, and the world can't, you know, undo it either. So it's like the world is completely useless in terms of any usage. Oh. It really can't serve me at all. What I want, I already have it. So how could the world serve me? And it can't get rid of it. What's already done is done. So it can't disserve me, can't serve me, can't do anything. Why pay even attention? Why hope and fear? Why hope and fear? There's no more space for hope and fear. The world's all about hope and fear, isn't it? To me, hope and fear is completely irrelevant, totally indifferent to hope and fear. What's already done is already done. I'm already there. So what does the world have to do with being already there? Nothing. Nothing at all. What does hope and fear have to do with the fact that I'm already there? I'm already here. It has nothing to do with it at all. So I can't tell you what's going on in the world. Occasionally people say something, this and that. You know, turmoil, all this stuff. And the Holy Spirit sometimes gives me a heads up about this or that. We had thieves on our street yesterday in broad daylight, stealing, going from all the cars, opening the cars up and if they're unlocked and stealing what was inside. It was amazing because I left early that day. Otherwise, I would have gotten everything stolen. I have a lot of stuff that there could be stolen. And I would have everything stolen except that one day I needed to leave real early. I left real early. And the thieves, I wasn't there. Thieves missed out on a bonanza. Thank the grace of the Holy Spirit for that, right? Grace of the Guru for that. So I just trust in the gurus, that's all. I trust them. The super gurus, I trust them. They make a promise. They make a promise to be. They promised. That's good enough for me. It's a done deal. It's already done. If they promise that they're going to, that I'm going to be freed and awakened and recognized realization, you know, if they promise that, then it's a done deal. It's already done for, in my mind. So there's nothing I have to do about it. It's done already. They will see to it. They've already seen to it. So there's nothing the world can do about that. Once the guru guarantees it, the world is finished in that regard, you know. It's a done deal, already a done deal. No hope and fear involved. So interest in hope and fear begins to vanish. And we then realize that the world is nothing but hope and fear. And so your interest in the world is vanished, is gone without a trace. That's okay. Don't need hope and fear. Don't need hope and fear. Well, we managed to go for an hour, didn't we? So this is actually cold tonight, so I think I'm gonna go inside. But more heat wave is coming. Going back and forth between cold and heat wave, really oscillating the weather right now. Very odd. Hot and cold, hope and fear. Hot and cold, hope and fear. Me, all hope and fear is gone. Without a trace, all hope and fear completely vanished. I have no idea what it even feels like. I have no memory of what it feels like at all. So all this feeling of trouble, you know, I feel perfect. They say this, I feel perfect. Here's another practice. I feel perfect. I don't know why I feel perfect. I have no clue why I feel perfect. Okay, here's a great practice that came to today, Manjushri practice. I have no idea why I feel perfect, but I feel perfect. I feel absolutely perfect. I could be stupid and be feel perfect. I don't know. I could be real smart and feel perfect. I don't know. I have no idea what I am in terms, you know, of I just know I feel perfect. So I don't know if I'm smart or stupid or bad or good. I might be really bad, but I still feel perfect. I might be really good, but I still feel perfect. I feel perfect all the time. I might be in the past, but I still feel perfect. I might be in the future, but I still feel perfect. I might be in the now, but I still feel perfect. I feel inescapably perfect. There might be a reason that I'm feeling perfect, or there might not be any reason that I'm feeling perfect. Either way, I still feel perfect. And there isn't the slightest memory of all, at all of not feeling perfect. So I don't know what, I have no idea what could have caused this. Or maybe it's just not, nothing caused it at all. Whether it's caused or uncaused, doesn't matter, I still feel perfect. Caused or uncaused, I still feel perfect. So it doesn't matter. No hope, no fear at all. I just feel perfect constantly. That's all that I feel is just perfect. Perfect feeling. I have this perfect feeling. I don't know what caused it, or if anything. It doesn't matter whether, whatever caused it, it doesn't matter. I still feel perfect. Even if I'm seeking, I still feel perfect. Even if I think I'm sick, I still feel perfect. No matter what I do, I feel perfect. And I don't have any idea of what I'm doing, you know, it doesn't have any effect whatsoever on it. Nothing I do, nothing I think, nothing in the world, nothing has any effect on this feeling at all. Zero effect. I just feel perfect all the time. I just feel perfect right now. I just feel perfect always. I always feel perfect. Whether I search for why, I still feel perfect. Or whether I don't search for why, I still feel perfect. So there's nothing I can do at all to not feel perfect. There's an entire vast endless ocean of things I could try to feel perfect. And yet, even if I tried them all, I would still feel perfect. No matter what I try, I'm sitting here, I feel perfect. So as I look at this ocean of all sorts of endeavors and methods and techniques, etc., I realize it's futile. All that stuff, it... whether I did any of it or not, or all of it or not, makes no difference at all. I still feel exactly the same. Just exactly as I feel now. Perfect. Well, this is a very powerful, profound practice, no question about it. It's just tremendous. This is a Manjushri practice. So, we could take some pride in being connected with Manjushri. Okay, another one. Something happened. Something happened. Doesn't matter if something happens or something does not happen. I still feel perfect. So we just have to resign ourselves to this as inescapable, completely inescapable. Whether I think I've escaped or not, I still feel perfect. Whether I try or not, I still feel perfect. Whether I say I feel perfect or whether I deny it, I still feel perfect. I always feel perfect. Whether I know I feel perfect or don't know, I still feel perfect. Whether anybody knows, or everybody knows, or nobody knows, I still feel perfect. There's nothing that anything, nothing can happen to change that I feel perfect. Nothing at all. The absence of some happening, I still feel perfect. Happening, I still feel perfect. Whether that tree is here or not here, I still feel perfect. Whether the world is here or not here, I still feel perfect. I was made for the blues. Yeah. More. Still feel perfect, you know. So whether anything's happening or not happening, all this, you know, whether the world melts away or becomes beautiful or anything, I still feel perfect. There's nothing that anything can do for me to not feel perfect. I'm a perfect prisoner of perfection. Okay. A perfect prisoner of perfection. A perfect prisoner of perfection. And whether I accept it or not, I still feel perfect. Practice this. Whether I accept it or not makes no difference. I feel absolutely perfect. So all praise to Manjushri, to Jesus Christ, to Manjushri. Jesus Christ helped set this all up. All praise to Jesus Christ. All praise to Manjushri. All praise to Longchenpa. Praise to Buddha, the Bodhisattvas, the Nyingma masters, who truly know their business and have aligned us with super, super effective practice at this point in time of this, what we're going through, whatever's coming down the road. We are in great shape, super shape, inescapable, inescapably perfect shape, actually. Inescapably perfect shape. All right, very great. Keep your eyes open and see if you can just experience. You will find Juan Carlos. As long as you realize you've already found him. Okay? You will find Juan Carlos when you realize you've already found him. Very great. That's it for this one.